So
we're going to look at actually closing the distance between yourself and your opponent, okay, because when we spar more, we'll put the heavier arm tie up and clinch as well. So a couple ways we can do this, all right? I'm going to let Stephanie do her way, one of the two ways you can do it. This one's more of a combination, so if we're standing here just like this, you know, she's made her shots, and then and notice how she closed that distance up, okay? One more time. So again, this doesn't have to be done on the counter, where I'm doing this and she's coming in. That's one of the variations we can do it on. But a lot of time, I find that a little bit harder to do at times, okay? Because when we're stick sparring, we've gotten in a habit of doing this so much, back and back and back. But a lot of times, you won't get this full motion this way. You won't get a full swing. And if you do, we probably don't recognize it right off the bat, or we evade by getting out of the way completely. By countering, so if I'm here like this, she may counter by hitting my hand, bam, because she sees this coming, boom. Because that's what we've developed ourselves into as far as sparring. And I would say more, that's more of a sport aspect, you know what I mean? But since that's harder to get, we want to be able to create that opening for ourselves. So one of the ways we can create the opening, she fakes and hits the hand, you know, whatever she's doing, but then she's going to create it. Notice what she did. She shielded and roofed, forcing me to block or deflect. And this is where the balance nose come into play, and we'll work on those next week, okay? So if I'm here like this, she comes in again slowly, she shields, and then she roofs right there. So that puts me on the defensive right away, because she's coming forward by using her, I would say, zigzag or female triangle, cutting that angle. So she's faster than me going backwards. I'm on my heels. Okay, so one more time. We're here. She comes in, one, and two, just like that. Okay, and if I don't block on that second one, she comes again, one, two, she still gets in. Okay, so that's what we're going to do on this one. Okay, so one more time. We're here, she shields, she roofs, wraps over the arm. And notice she steps behind my leg. Okay, now this, she can put her head here. She can wrap over my arm. She can hold onto my waist. It all depends on what you feel comfortable with. Okay, and she puts her leg behind my leg. Okay, putting it on the inside is not bad either. It's up to you, but you have to make sure you take a deep step here and make sure your legs move down the waist, take me off base here. See the difference? So the initial one, the most common reaction, the most natural reaction is really to step to the outside. Because now what you've done, you've eliminated my way of retreating back here. So now I just can't take a normal step. So I actually have to create this space here, which is good for her. Take it off balance there. Okay? So that's what I want to look for.
You know where
oh, I didn't know you were putting it
up. All right, so again, one and two, she cuts in. You notice where her hand was at when she came in? That's a strike. She comes in, one, two. That's a shot to the face. Or obstruction IV. Any questions? So again, make sure you have your leg behind your partner here. Get a good trap on the arm above the elbow, okay? And keep your head close. By her eliminating the space, it makes it harder for me. I'm gonna naturally create the space by backing up. And that's gonna let her get to the set or back sweep or a kickback, what we call in JKD, a kickback. Okay, do it from this angle real quick. So we're here, you know, nothing's happening, she wants to close the distance, and there she is, right there. Okay, exactly. Any questions? Okay, let's try.